Oh, there goes my computer about to blow up. This is The Sims, so do whatever the hell you want. Hello, Grim Simmer here, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so that way you can be notified every single time I upload new Sims content. Do your builds in The Sims 4 always look like this? Well, if you want them to start looking like this, then keep on watching. Let's begin by going over shells and floor plans. I'll be giving you tips on balance and symmetry, open floor plans, and hallways. My first tip for a shell is to focus on symmetry and balance. A lot of people suggest starting with a box, but I don't like that approach personally because once I have a box, my head goes blank, like head empty. A box might be okay if a porch is the key focus of the exterior of a build, but for this one it's not. I went with an L-ish shape and you can see it sticks out 5 tiles wide on each side with peninsulas. I'm not sure what to call those. Either way, they balance each other out with their placement and how they line up with the rest of the house. For open floor plans, my advice is to split the house in half and make one wing for bedroom / bathrooms and another for the living room, dining room, and kitchen. And it should always be in that order, either living room, dining room, kitchen, or kitchen, dining room, living room. But realistically, you rarely walk through a house in real life and are immediately in the kitchen unless it's an apartment. So if that matters to you, keep that in mind. You can also use Pinterest or Google, of course, for floor plans and interior ideas. I know I sure do. Also, don't forget about the importance of hallways. No matter if it's a lengthy hallway or just a cutout into a room, do it. I cannot tell you how many times I see builds with a bedroom door in the middle of a wall connected to a dining room or something. You tell me what looks better here, a flat wall with doors like this, or a simple cutout hallway separating the space. Now let's discuss roofing and trims, specifically roof styles and trim color consistency. I'm going to briefly go over the rules that I follow for roofing, and this is totally subjective, but this is just what I do. So for suburban builds, I normally use triangle roofs or the whole roofs, modern builds, half walls or sloped roofs, Victorian / cottage style roofing, triangle roofs with roof altering tools to make it more curved or concaved, and with the edged circle roofs. Asian style, use the circle roofs, whole roofs, or triangle roofs with roof altering as well for more concaving. Again, this is totally subjective, but I find that this is what works best for me. For roofing, you also want to make sure that your roof trim color matches all of the railings, the stairs, the windows, and half wall trims if you have any throughout the entire build, so that way there's some form of cohesiveness. Again, that's also totally subjective, but I find that that works best for my builds personally. Exterior colors. I'll be covering contrast and the color wheel. I cannot stress this enough, but use contrasting colors. It'll help make the build look more aesthetically pleasing if this is something that you struggle with. For this build, I went with a dark exterior but a light roof, light accent chimney, light windows, and light stairs. Because the colors are so different, they help complement each other. Which leads me to my next point. The color wheel is your friend. It's also just The Sims though, so if you're pulling out a color wheel, you really have to care. But if you're really into this, use a color wheel. It works by choosing a color and then pairing it with the color directly across from it in the wheel, and then voila, you have at least colors that match and go together. Oh, I also forgot to mention this when I was talking about roofing, but your doors, for the most part, should also match your roofing trims, and so should any fencing. I know I mentioned railings already, but the little fencing as well that I use also matches the trim, which really pulls it together. Are these even tips, or am I just super picky when I build? I have no idea. I hope this is helping someone. So now let's talk about landscaping. I'll be covering how to choose your plants, how to balance out your build, and how to use landscaping to your advantage. I like to build with plants that are common in the world I'm building with to make sure that my build doesn't stick out. Once I narrow it down, I like to choose about 3 to 4 plants that I plan on keeping consistent throughout my entire build. In the end, this definitely makes the build look more complete and put together. Oh, there goes my computer about to blow up. If you didn't know this already, I play on a Mac, so it's actually really hard for my computer to record my screen and play The Sims at the same time. Moving on, landscape can really balance out a build. So I have that chimney on the right side, and in the end, I end up adding a big tree in the backyard in the back left corner if you're facing the front of the house, which kind of offsets that weird balance that the chimney has because it's so much higher than the rest of the build. Sometimes I also like to do one tree in the back corner and then another tree in the front yard in the opposing corner, if that makes sense, diagonal from each other, which really helps, again, offset the build and make it a little bit more balanced. This last tip for landscaping, I honestly live by. I believe that you can make any house, no matter how horrible, look amazing with the use of landscape. If your landscaping makes sense and looks put together, it is truly going to save your build. Plus, you can hide a lot of things with a tree or some bushes, so I definitely recommend, when in doubt, add landscaping. And lastly, the interior. I'll be covering lines of sight, themes, and how to use accent walls. I like to make sure that for most of my builds, my front door and backyard door are centered with each other and visible from each side of the house. It creates this beautiful line of sight that catches your eye right when you walk in. And if you can't put a slider there, I also try to put a regular window that's typically ceiling to floor. But lining things up like this can really go a long way. I also line up the dining table with a big window here in this build because one, it would bother me if it wasn't centered, but also it helped me mark out that area of the room as the dining area. I feel like this should go without saying, but if your floor plan is open, the kitchen, dining, and living room areas should easily flow together. Make sure your colors match and complement each other. You'll notice that I used earth tones once again in all of the living common areas of the build, but pick three key colors and just stick with it throughout these spaces. For accent walls, a brick wall, sliding, or special kind of wall can really fill up a room that looks empty and generally makes it look a lot more interesting. However, be careful using too many different accent walls because it can get messy really quick. I think the general rule of thumb in real life is to make the accent wall slightly darker if you're just using paint, but this is The Sims, so do whatever the hell you want. And speaking of doing whatever the hell you want, please remember that these are just tips and tricks that I personally use, and what works for me might not work for you. So take these as seriously as you want or take it with a grain of salt. It doesn't really matter, but hopefully you got something out of this video. Like I said, it is still just The Sims at the end of the day. If you want to have a hot pink house with hot pink walls and like hot green carpet, do it. Do whatever you want. If that makes you happy, do it. Actually, I don't think I started caring about my builds until I started watching speed builds like religiously. So it definitely influenced me a lot on how I build. If I haven't mentioned this already, this is a base game starter home, and I tried to keep it under 30,000 simoleons. It ends up being 16 simoleons over, but I didn't know what to delete to make it less, so I just left it. So hopefully that's fine. So that's why a lot of the furniture in the build is kind of ugly and kind of plain, because it is base game. It actually gave me a good opportunity to use the beige wood detail set, which I never really used before, but I actually think it looks kind of good. At least I think I used it well. I also really want to go back into this build and decorate it with all of my packs and just completely finish it without the budget constraint, because I feel like this build has a lot of potential, especially with that big backyard. I definitely want to go back in and finish it. If you want to download this build and play in it, my gallery ID is Cassie Probably. I actually downloaded this from the gallery already myself just to get some more b-roll shots of it, but I noticed that there were a couple things missing from the build, like one of the chairs from the backyard table is missing, the sink in the kitchen ends up missing, and the bench that I put in the front porch is also missing. Just keep that in mind, I'm sorry, because I use move objects, so just make sure that you have that on before you download. If you do decide to download this and renovate it, please show me and tag me on Twitter or Instagram. My Twitter is @GrimSimmer. And my Instagram is GrimSimmerYT. Towards the end here, I try and include as many recreational and skill building options that I could, but really with the budget constraint that I had and the interior that I wanted to make, I was only able to include that TV, and then I have a little bookshelf in the room closer to the front. So there's really not too much here, but this is a starter home, so hopefully your Sim rakes it in with some cash. Maybe they go to university or something, they make that big money. Hopefully they're able to acquire more objects that they can put in this house. And plus, with this big backyard, there's definitely room for a lot of expansion here. This house overall has a lot of potential. These are all of the tips for today's base game starter home build mode tips. I'm thinking about turning this into a mini series, so let me know in the comments down below what kind of things you need tips on when building or decorating, and I'll use it for a video in the future. If you stuck around until the very end, thank you so much, and I hope you learned something new in this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so that way you can be notified every single time I upload new Sims content. Now that I've listened back to this voiceover, I sound kind of down. I'm sorry if it's not as interesting or as funny. I mean, assuming you think I'm funny, I'm just going through a lot right now, and this YouTube channel is the only thing that I'm putting any kind of energy into, so thank you so much for your support, no matter how you show it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!